Here we have a binary vapor that's at 150 degrees C and 1.5 bar, and the mole fraction of component A is 0.6. So what we're going to do is lower the temperature to 100 degrees C, keeping the pressure constant, and we find that a significant fraction of the vapor condenses. The liquid that we form is ideal. We're given saturation pressures, and what we want to determine are what are the compositions of the liquid and the vapor at 100 degrees C, namely what are their mole fractions, and then what fraction of our original vapor condenses. So it's easiest to help visualize this process by first looking at a Txy diagram to see what's happening. The idea is on a Txy diagram, this is temperature, and x-axis mole fractions. We start at 0.6 and 150 degrees C, and we get to a point where a significant fraction is condensed. So this corresponds to 100 degrees C. And we're trying to determine XA and YA, the values that are at equilibrium, and then the fraction of liquid and the fraction of vapor. Because this is ideal solution, we can use Raoult's law, which says the mole fraction of A in the liquid times the saturation pressure of A is the mole fraction of A in the gas phase times the total pressure. And then the corresponding equation for component B. So we're going to substitute in the values that we have in the problem statement. And a simple way to solve these equations is to add the two equations together. So the left side is 2xA plus xB. The right side is 1.5. YA plus YB, since YA plus YB is 1, that's 1.5, and of course XA plus XB must add to 1. So we can then solve this for XA. So this gives us the mole fraction of A in the liquid phase, and we can go back to this equation. Here we know XA. So we can solve for YA, which is 0.67. So we've done the first part. We've determined the compositions, the mole fractions of the two phases. So now we want to determine the fraction of the vapor that condenses. And so what we're going to do is a mass balance. The overall mole fraction of A at the start times total of 1 mole is equal to mole fraction of A in the liquid phase times the number of moles in the liquid phase plus the mole fraction of A in the vapor phase times the number of moles in the vapor phase. So this is 0.6 times 1, and this is 0.5. We're solving for the liquid, 0.67. Well, the vapor and the liquid must add to 1, so the vapor is 1 minus the liquid. So we can do the math here. So the fraction of the original 1 mole, or the fraction that's liquid at equilibrium, is 0.41, which says 41% of the original vapor condenses at 100 degrees C.